I'm Mary Portas. This week, I'm off to South London. Boutique owners Max and Becky think they've spotted a gap in the market, giving young professionals a hip look.
We have things that are just a little bit more special, like things like this.
Tracksuits like this. I wouldn't jog around a common in this, I'd go out in it.
But I reckon those clothes are more down and dirty than upwardly mobile, and the locals aren't buying it either.
Is it me?
Is it the shop?
I really wouldn't like to lose this.
So I'm giving Max and Becky 5 weeks of my time to show them what they're doing wrong.
We might have to close this. Cute girls with some old slapper at the bar and an evening up the back.
When I dress, I like to make a statement for myself.
You do not touch his hands.
I failed. Sorry.
I'm heading to Rumplestiltskin Boutique for my first visit. It's in Balham, an up-and-coming area of South London.
You've got this part of London that really has started to have all those kind of nice, cool little bars. It's kind of upwardly mobile.
And so are the people.
20-somethings, early 30s, professionals. They're not probably the most leading-edge fashion people, but they want to look good.
The boutique is off Balham's main high road, and that's about as far from a fashion destination as you can get.
I've got Caribbean food wholesalers on one side, Yang Chen Chinese chicken on the other, and the whole street is practically full. There's a fish shop there, of food shops. So any business, sitting themselves amongst this, have got to be super brilliant, super destination, and look amazing.
But unfortunately, Rumplestiltskin has fallen at the first hurdle.
I just see a random few old mannequins lined up with a bit of fur on the floor. I don't even get the fashion. It looks like kind of market store fashion, and it just looks cheap.
I'm not surprised the locals have been giving this a wide berth, but I can't. I'm here to have a look round and to meet the people in charge.
Hello.
How are you, Mary?
Hi, I'm good.
My name's Max.
Hi, Max.
This is Becky.
I'm Becky.
Hello, Becky. Is it your shop or is it your shop?
It's both of
our shop.
It's our shop.
Yes.
Okay. You know, I'm not getting a feel for it from outside, what it stands for.
I wanted here to be a stopgap so you could come in here and buy something really fun for a Saturday night, a Friday night out, without getting on the tube and going down to the West End.
Okay.
Becky's also a stylist, and she shares the buying of the collections with Max. And 40 months ago, he was a personal trainer. So what does he know about selling fashion?
Is this you? I'm guessing you buy the menswear.
If we can start at the beginning, something like this, fantastic cardigan.
So is this how you'd sell it to a customer?
Well, I've got it on, so I always showed him the grey one and say it comes in black as well.
What's that number? Do you go around in that as well?
No, it's not my favourite piece, but customers do like it. They do sell. People do like them. Balham's evolving daily. You know,
oh, yeah.
Different types of customers on a daily basis.
What type of customer is that?
Anyone who walks down Hilda Street. There's fruit and veg stores this side. It was a market before, and now it's turned into, you know, little Europe.
Blimey, you should be out there giving that pat. It's little Europe, little market store.
Well, that's what it is out there.
Max is trying to flannel me. I get the feeling he doesn't actually know as much as he thinks he does.
Something like this, I think, is really nice.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's now fashion for now.
I don't know what fashion for now that is, because that's some chick who's going to have confidence to wear that.
So far, all I've seen are a random mix of odds and sods rather than a cohesive collection. It's a clear sign to me that this pair are confused about who their boutique is for.
Who is the customer in Balham?
We want to aim for the householder, you know, the affluent person in Balham, people with money, people with disposable cash.
OK, so the house owner...
Yeah.
Professional?
The yummy mummy, yeah.
The yummy mummy.
Yeah.
OK. She's not going to be going out in this jacket. She isn't. Wearing T-shirts like this, the old Magaluf bar dress up the back, she is not going to be wearing. The dress up here, split up to the waist, mummy yummy after you had the baby, is not going to be codging it round Balham in that at a bar. This is the sort of thing my, you know, 11-year-old daughter would wear and her mates of 14, 15. I mean, you to wear that length, that is not saying to me late 20s, early 30s, you know, professional people who don't want to go to the West End.
It's not only the clothes that are ill-suited to grown-ups, it's the decor. Max and Becky have created a look that's better suited to a youth club.
It's quite an aggressive visual, you know. It's not really saying safe, accessible, cool fashion. Mm-hmm. It's quite out there. So I've got a real, real mix in here. And if I was a customer coming in, I'd be confused. Definitely. Because you're confused.
Mm-hmm. With Becky's experience, I'd have expected her to be far more focused. So what's gone wrong?
Now, you started this because you have a passion for fashion and shopping.
Definitely.
So where's it all gone?
It's been suppressed, I think. It's definitely there, but I've lost that drive that I had before.
You lost it.
If Becky doesn't know what to sell or who she's selling to, I'm not surprised her business is failing.
So after all your overheads, mm-hmm. where are you getting to?
After all my overheads, I'm just paying bills and that's it, and putting stuff back on the shelf. I'm not taking a wage or anything like that from here at all.
And Max isn't taking a wage?
No.
I think Becky and Max are locked in their own little world, but that's about to change. If those locals aren't coming to Rumplestiltskin, we're going to take the clothes to them.
What I want you to do is to go around the shop and I want you to pick five pieces each that you're proud of and you think this is for my customer. This I feel is right and this sums up my boutique, and I want you to do the same, Max, for your geezer. And then I'm going to pick five that I think sums up the boutique when I look round it.
We'll be taking the best and the worst of the Rumplestiltskin collection on to Balham High Street. Balham's a hotspot for young, affluent professionals, and it's time Becky and Max found out what these potential shoppers make of their clothes.
Is there anything on there? And I want your honest opinion, OK? Tell me what you think, or is there anything on there that you might wear?
Does this shop sell clothes for children?
Is that... it's not, it's just a very short skirt, is it?
What about that?
I think that's quite nice, actually, but I probably am too old to wear that.
How about this?
Too pink, probably.
Something like this?
I quite like it. I normally don't go for sort of very commercial sort of logo kind of thing.
That's a bit too short for me.
That's too short for you, yeah. And how old are you?
21. No, I wouldn't wear that.
Okay. It's a bit too kind of in your face for me.
Would you wear this?
No.
Probably. No? How about this?
No, definitely not.
Definitely not. No. Right, this one?
No way.
No?
Not with a tie.
No, I'm far too old.
Now, come on.
The locals we've stopped have been in their late 20s to their early 30s, and yet these clothes have proved to be too young, too flash, too naff.
Maybe a bit student-y.
But they know what they like, and it's important Becky and Max know too.
Where do you shop? What sort of shops do you shop in?
All Saints. I love, yeah. All Saints. They're quite funky.
I'll go up into town, yeah, Oxford Circus.
Topshop or okay. H&M and all them
sort
of places.
But if you had a shop here that sold the right fashion for you, would you shop it?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay.
I noticed you've got a Louis Vuitton bag, so yeah. You don't mind spending a lot of money on fashion?
No.
Yeah? So would you... If it was the right stuff, would you...
If it was the right stuff, I would.
So the locals are going to the West End for their premium high street labels. That means they're buying stylish fashion that's not too edgy.
But I don't think they was too critical on everything.
No, the classic guy who wore the Ralph Lauren and was designer found it all too much.
Yeah.
If you're going to make money...
That's right, yeah.
..and you want a taste level that is for the late 20s, early 30s, most of this stuff isn't right.
It's hard to hear criticism and, yeah, it's hard hearing it from her, but I also know that it's constructive because it's things that I need to know to make an improvement in this business, and I do want to improve it, so I have to take it on board and kind of take it on my chest.
The collection is wrong. The shop is in off-piste beyond, next to the fruit and veg, and nobody knows about it. So that's as big as it gets, really.
But all is not lost. Becky's got one thing right. The people of Balham are getting their shopping fix in the West End. And who can blame them? Here, there's every high street retailer and major label you could ever want.
Becky can't compete with this. This is the West End. But they don't have to, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to cherry pick the right labels and the best ones for their shop and deliver a little touch of West End to Balham High Street. It'll be actually a one-stop fashion convenience shop.
If I'm going to deliver that, first I need to know if Becky and Max have what it takes to choose and sell fashion to those young Balham professionals. This morning I've asked them to meet me at world-famous department store Selfridges on Oxford Street.
Because what I want you to do today is to go around Selfridges and I want you to pick out fashion.
Yes.
That you think these people are going to wear, OK?
Yes.
And I've got a gang of late 20s, early 30s people who you are going to style later on. Absolutely your target market.
My guinea pigs are house sharers. They're just the kind of people Max and Becky should be selling to. Young, Balham professionals who love to shop and they know exactly what they like.
Nothing too fashionable, no big labels.
Quite classic, things that I can wear rather than they wear me.
I probably wouldn't like to wear chinos and a blazer.
The clothes I don't wear is chav wear.
You can't.
I wouldn't wear. I tell you something that's quite fashionable at the moment, which I think is kind of cool, but I wouldn't wear it. Skinny jeans.
Max and Becky now have 1 hour to find them an outfit each. I've arranged for us to have the run of Selfridges. Becky and Max have got the pick of some of the premium high street brands. Cause you're filthy, ooh, gorgeous. But not every label here is right for that understated shopper.
That's going to be a dressy up piece, isn't it?
Yeah.
You know?
I was thinking of the fat with jeans to have a nice little coat on top.
Becky and Max have to remember what they heard from those locals. Fashionable, but not flash. Nothing too young and nothing too short.
No.
Kit's tip.
Thank you very much. This could be quite cute. Maybe with the jeans. Very nice.
Given access to suitable collections, Becky seems confident. But I'm not sure about Max. Is he shopping for his customer or himself?
Well, this is lovely. That's a good look.
Now we're heading back to Balham, where Becky and Max will have to dress the locals in the outfits they've picked out for them.
It's about really understanding their style, and it's not going to be about your personal style or your personal style. And that's what great buying is about. Mm. You've got to make that decision today. Can I do this, OK?
Hi,
Kate!
Nice to meet you.
This is an important test. It's going to show me if Max and Becky are up to the job of buying the right sort of collections for these potential shoppers.
Who's going to wear that?
OK, boys, get changed. What are you waiting for?
All right,
let's
do it.
What's the problem? Trousers down first, please.
While Max is still deciding who to put in what, Becky's got her ladies dressed in their new outfits.
Here we have a lovely caramel and coat.
I do like this. Good. It's very nice.
Did you like the coat?
Yeah,
really like the coat.
And Kate's in All Saints.
Really beautiful.
And the rest of the outfit?
Yeah, I think it's absolutely gorgeous.
This is my Sunday afternoon look. The jacket's by Topshop. Very casual, very comfortable, and some diesel jeans.
Definitely 10 out of 10. And I love the sleeveless jacket.
Yeah.
You wear a tighter top underneath. It's a bit of a different look.
Even with a long-sleeve T-shirt, I thought it would look really well.
Cross-season, fantastic.
Yeah. I love this.
I really love the simplicity
of this.
This coat's from French Connection.
This sort of shape is something that I wear. It's that sort of chiffon-y fabric.
That's lovely. That's very good. Great. Well done.
Becky's nailed it by picking clothes from labels that are fashionable but not too outrageous.
Guys, come.
Now for hubby Max. His challenge to choose relaxed pieces that aren't too trendy.
Number three and number four. This is like your band boy look, yeah? So we have the tie to emphasise a bit of smartness. Everything's very fitted.
I'm not sure about the jacket at all. It's a bit shiny for me. I'm kind of more understated than this jacket, and also the jeans are a little bit tight.
Ben, is it you?
No. Nice classic cut, wool, keep it warm, looks good, put a scarf with it, it's just tidy, I think so.
But it's not something he feels at all connected with?
A little bit of education in fashion might help.
All right, Max, and you're going to give it to him?
Well...
Go on, then.
I think this is very smart. It's very safe. There's nothing...
Oh, yeah, no, I'm not denying that, but it does make you feel as though it's... But you like, look, private school kid...
It's very smart.
...going down the road, just come out of school.
Next.
Yeah, this is just speaks for itself. Everybody will wear this. This is classic, definitely.
It's not something I'd wear all the time. I don't know. I just feel that's a little bit too old for my age.
Unfortunately, Max has recreated the flash Rumplestiltskin look. But even more worryingly, he's now bullying his potential customers.
I wouldn't necessarily buy jeans this sort of skinny.
For me, I think that men's fashion is evolving really quickly and we have to catch up to it.
I don't care. I go out in a shirt and a pair of jeans. That's all I care about.
I like to make a statement for myself.
Yeah,
not
you
what my
do,
missus
but I,
wants me
yeah,
to wear.
But I don't. I don't care.
It's a real shame Max missed the mark with the clothes, but that's not my biggest concern.
Max is still doing the hard sell. Well, I'm telling you, it's right for you. You know what, Max? People don't want that. Fashion shopping is about knowing that customer and in a casual, beautiful way, connecting with them and dressing them.
Max's fashion inexperience shows, but right now that's not my biggest problem. In 3 weeks' time, Rumplestiltskin has to become a boutique that can tempt those young locals from shopping in the West End. They wouldn't be seen dead in most of these collections. So we need to invest in new ones. And this morning, I'm meeting Becky and Max to talk money.
Are you losing money?
Right now, I'd definitely say yes.
How much are you losing?
Well, at the moment, we're about £10,000 down.
£10,000 down. Do you have any money in the business, or are you absolutely...
Well, the business has eaten up any reserves that we did have.
It's a big one, because I... Normally, when I look at the business, we have to have some sort of funds that we need to buy our new collections going forward. We really are in a dire straits.
If this boutique isn't making money, why has Max given up a wage as a personal trainer to work for nothing?
I personally think since I've come here that I have contributed a lot to this company. We are still losing money, but it's been an improvement. A little bit of something's better than a lot of nothing.
You've got to make some money. A little bit of nothing is not going to feed your family. I know this is tough. I'm not coming in here to think, oh, let's put a nice coat of paint up and let's get some nice frocks in. I've got to make this business profitable. I feel this personally. And you've got to take this seriously. What money are we making in this business? How are we going to live our life? Because actually, we might have to close this bloody thing. We might have to close this.
I want to succeed. I've got 3 kids, and I don't want them. I don't want to show them the way is failure, because it really isn't. And once I shut that door and put that clothes on up, I've failed. Sorry.
I'm beginning to realise that the news that there's no money left isn't just a surprise to me.
Becky, come on. Just talk to me. Did you know that it was this bad?
No, because I try...
You try and hide it? Is Max in charge of the numbers?
Yeah, because I try my best to keep out of it, because I don't... Because I knew it was doing badly. But I suppose Max tries to protect me from...
Is that where you see your role, Max, as protecting her from the truth?
No, my role is protect her from as much as possible.
You can't take that all on your shoulders, mate.
I don't mind. Becky's quite an emotional person, so I don't mind taking that on my shoulders.
But, Becky, I know you're upset, but you know that you've got to face...
I know I do, and I want to, but when you hear it like that, it's just...
You are not going to hide finances, and neither are you going to hide your head under the bloody frocks. You will know what these finances are. We are in a crap situation. OK? And we have to work like hell to turn this around. We have no money. We have no image. We have the wrong product. It can't get any worse. We will do it. You know what the upside is? You actually have a market out there.
Yeah.
It really upsets me to see them like that. It does upset me. But I can't let this upset me because I have to move this forward very, very quickly. If this doesn't work, they have no source of income and they have three children and a mortgage. That is frightening, and I take that responsibility very personally. I think this is going to have to be the biggest favour-pulling exercise that I'm going to have to go on.
They say, mind what you wish for, because we needed someone to come in and, you know, give this business a whole shake-up, and Mary's come.
Given the financial bombshell, I've set Max and Becky the task of making some much-needed ready cash. Whilst I start the hunt for new collections, they're going to get rid of their old ones.
We're going to get all the old stock that we've got downstairs and try and sell it off as cheap as possible, just to accumulate some money.
Lovely coat.
So we're going to get everything out, put it out on the stall and just get rid of it.
Today, Max's Barra Boy sales technique is going to be spot on. He's booked a stall at Balham's local market.
Any jumper for a tenner? £5 T-shirts. £5 T-shirts. Come on, catch a bargain. Yeah, come and catch a bargain.
Have a little look through there, see what you see.
You got anything for the girls?
Girls in the other side.
How long are you going to be there for?
Just one day, mate. T-shirts, £5. Any T-shirt, £5.
Do you have anything for sort of teenage boys?
Teenage boys, yeah. We've got the khaki look. Actually, yeah. Comes in a red as well. We've got a couple more over here. Some more ladies' T-shirts over there. So far, we've made about £280, which is fantastic. We're halfway through the day at the moment, so hopefully by the end of the day, we can double this and get some money behind us. Come and get your bargains here. Come and catch a bargain now. Any T-shirt for a fiver. All hats, £8. Just try it, try it.
Max and Becky's collections could have sat in the stockroom forever.
Thank you very much, ladies.
But in the right setting, at knockdown prices, they're finally getting those shoppers to part with their cash.
That's £10, please. And may you have fun in it.
Well, you say you got a bargain. Yeah, well done.
Thank you very much.
Thanks. Better than business with you guys.
You too, honey bun.
I'm going to pop these inside, then.
Okay.
Getting rid of those old collections has not only given us some spending money, it's making space for the new. I want to attract those local 20 to 30-somethings by replacing those flashy, trashy clothes with desirable collections that are currently on offer just a tube ride away. I've tracked down a label that's doing big business in the West End. Mina is a Korean designer that established her label in the UK 3 years ago. Her speciality is the dress trend that won't go away, the smock. Its versatile shape suits all sizes and has become a real high street favourite.
Hello.
Hello.
Stocking Mina at Rumplestiltskin will mean those Balham ladies won't have to travel to the West End for their fix.
This is one of our, like, very distinctive Mina style empire line. Mm-hmm. Very vivid, like, colourful prints, which is a very unique style of ours. This is, like, one of our current items. We sold, like,
leggings and
things. Yeah, with leggings and, like, again, with big belts, because mm-hmm. it seems yeah. to be the trend right of now. The moment.
Yes.
Yeah.
This collection is the pretty cute little frocks. They sell them very well in Topshop. And I just think these are going to be perfect for you.
I've also chosen it for Max and Becky because they can order small amounts of stock that they don't have to pay for up front.
Oh. Does that mean you've always got new stock coming in consistently?
Yeah, that's definitely. Great. Every 2 weeks we have 3 or 4 new styles coming in.
Excellent.
I want to feel that your shop is changing all the time with like current styles, that's like really moving important. On.
I'm pleased Becky and Max are into this label, because unbeknown to them, I've already placed an order. And a couple of miles away at Deloitte Business Services in the city, I've created for them their very own pop-up shop. I'm about to show Becky and Max how different life can be with the right collection and the right shopper.
I have got the collection here. I want you to look at this, merchandise it the way you want. Mannequins. You got a little catwalk show on the video, and you have a captive audience coming in and out of this lift constantly, OK? I don't want you out the front like the market boy, right? But you need to capture them. Do you decide how you're going to do that? And think about those sales techniques. You think about those styling techniques. And I really, really want to see these rails pretty damn empty.
This is Max and Becky's chance to make some much-needed cash, so I want to see them pulling out all the stops.
Yeah, don't put that dress on. No, don't put that on the mannequin.
Why, it's too dark.
Yeah, put some bright things on. I'm hoping for lots of sales and lots of money today.
The Mina dresses are doing the trick. They're catching the eye of the women heading out for lunch. But now Max and Becky need to keep them interested.
So just take your time and have a look through. If you need anything, just give me a shout.
Thank you.
Okay, honey.
Becky's off to a flying start.
We've got it featured just there on that mannequin. It is quite cute on.
She's offering really good style advice, just what these shoppers should expect to get from a brilliant boutique.
Oh, lovely. And do you see how you could wear it through the day like that, and with a nice pair of heels, it just transforms into something for the evening?
Is it meant to be a bit loose rather than...
No. Just like that. It's just how it's meant to sit. How it's sitting on you is perfect. I think with a lovely little cardigan, you'd be fine.
Does it make me look younger?
And her tips are paying off.
That's 138, please. Thank you very much.
But there's a problem. This woman's obviously looking to buy, but that dress isn't right for her.
That one actually comes in a black as well.
It's not the colour that's the problem. Max should be pulling out a style that will suit her, but he's flummoxed. Max can't afford for this to happen at Rumplestiltskin.
I don't know whether you feel that comfortable standing looking at a young woman and really advising her on fashion.
It's not something I've thought about into enough detail to think about it like that.
That's what you've got to do. You've got to be careful that you don't have them as this kind of alien creature that's so different. Yeah. They're people.
Yes, definitely.
And you've got to be able to have that kind of wonderful, casual way of connecting with them.
Max needs to make these women feel excited about this collection. But he seems to have forgotten about Mina's designs altogether.
What is it, the weather has changed or something like that? You know, it's a bit hot and it's a bit cold and it's raining, not quite sure what to wear at the moment, isn't it? It's a bit half a dozen of one and six of the other, isn't it?
Yet again, Max's inexperience shows he's out of his depth. But thankfully, Becky is going from strength to strength.
She's a natural. Because I wouldn't be here if you weren't. You know, Max, it's important. And it might be that you don't spend that much time on the sales floor. I have to look at that.
Yeah, well, now you've said it, it does seem a bit more like a possibility.
If Max is going to stay on the shop floor at Rumplestiltskin, he's got a lot to learn.
Max is just not a natural fashion stylist, and that's what this is about. She is, no problem.
Max isn't out of a job yet. To turn Rumplestiltskin around, we have to create a new image for the boutique. And I'm hoping he'll show more talent behind the scenes.
Hi, guys.
Hello.
I want to completely change the look of Rumplestiltskin so it attracts those 30-something affluent locals.
I just feel that what we've got at the moment is just a little bit kind of urban. A little bit too street, but I just think we need to make it a little bit more sophisticated.
Yes,
a little bit more chic.
Definitely.
The window, maybe something could...
Windows are bad bit. Yeah. And that bit of old shag pile on the floor.
Yeah.
Where'd you get that? At the back of your car, mate? It's the bit you got
there. It actually feels quite nice under your feet.
I'm sure it feels nice under your feet or your back, but it's not in the window, OK? Now, the problem is we've got no dosh. So we've got to think how we do this. Who's going to paint the front, Max? Who's going to be out there on that ladder with
me.
No money?
Me, yes.
Maxie boy.
I don't mind.
He doesn't mind, does he?
I don't mind.
Oh, you're a good lad. We're going to have to do that.
Over the next week, there's a lot to achieve. With only one collection on board, I still need to find a major label that's big enough to make locals think twice before they go west. We need to get the word out that Rumplestiltskin is changing, so Becky is hitting the streets.
Hi there, ladies.
Hi.
Hi, guys. We're relaunching our store around the corner called Rumplestiltskin.
So is it one of that one? It's there?
Yeah, just over there. I'd just like to invite you along for the relaunch party.
Max and his band of merry men have made a start on turning my plans for a contemporary stylish boutique into reality. So it's goodbye to the youth club look.
Ah, this blue's nice.
Becky's come up with an idea to make the shop launch an attractive proposition for those local shoppers.
This is the invitation. If you bring three friends along, you get a 10% discount.
Well, it is my birthday coming up soon.
So is it men's and women's?
Yes, yes, okay. Yes. You and can get your boyfriend's presents as well.
Okay.
Bring three friends along, you get 10%
discount.
There's nine friends.
Yeah.
Well, I think I've only got three.
Okay.
No, yeah, okay.
All of them can come in.
A few days of good old hard graft by Max and the dark urban decor is all but gone, and emerging is the beginnings of a classic boutique.
Mind stepping here, look behind me. I like final touches, Adi. See your creation come together. Best feeling in the world. This is what I've done.
Max has rolled his sleeves up, but if he's going to play a part in the success of this boutique, there's a lot more to come.
Back on.
I want Rumplestiltskin to offer those locals a taste of the West End. And to pull that off, we've got to offer a professional sales approach. So I've got some work to do on Max. And I'm starting here. Jermyn Street is home to Turnbull and Asser, a gents' outfitters selling luxury attire. From the finest silk shirts to handmade ties to the softest cashmere socks a man could want. But it's the impeccable service that brings customers back year after year. I've arranged for Max to learn the techniques they use here to ensure Sir remains a regular customer.
Right, Max. So I'm going to let you see how these guys understand selling to men. And then you can try and apply those rules, even though it's to a different market.
Definitely.
Okay, yeah. Come on, let's take a look inside. Rowley, hi.
Mary.
Nice to see you.
I'm hoping Turnbull and Asser's Roland Low McKenzie can turn Max from bruiser to smoothie in just a morning.
Yep.
So this guy is going to look after you. And you're going to come back the best salesman, aren't you, Max?
Definitely.
Right, where to start? As you're in Turnbull and Asser, mm-hmm. we should dress you as one of our staff and then get you on the shop floor and learning the techniques of how to sell.
Yes.
I must confess, what a transformation.
Thank you.
That is immaculate.
Yes, I feel really good as well.
Max is about to learn that selling fashion isn't as easy as just hanging around on the shop floor.
The do's and don'ts.
Okay.
Don't slouch.
Slouch, yeah.
This is the biggest no-no. It's just appalling behaviour. Beautiful product. Don't. Just slam it down on the desk. Show the customer the product.
Yes.
Presentation. It's all romancing the product. Mm-hmm.
Now Rowley's bravely letting Max loose on one of his most valued customers.
This is the sales assistant who will be looking after you for your sale.
Nice to meet you, sir.
Max, big no-no. Customer, you do not touch his hands. If he puts his hands out first, okay, then you go. Never the other way around. Okay. This gentleman may have felt very uncomfortable for you doing that. Mm-hmm. So always remember, body politics. The customer is the god, and, you know, you have to worship the ground he walks on because he's got the dosh.
Okay, yes.
Not a great start. Right. Let's hope he does better when it comes to selling his wares.
Were you looking for anything in particular?
I'm looking for a very thin shirt.
Okay.
Size 16 and a half.
Mm-hmm.
Don't throw it down, Max. Please, remember, just put it down on the counter.
Sorry.
Sorry, sir. What I would suggest is to help the customer. to show him the quality of the actual fabrics. Mm-hmm. It's all about tactility, so the customer can actually feel the quality.
Okay, yes. Feel this one and feel this one, and you notice the quality difference. How does that feel? Is that okay?
This is finer.
Max should be talking up the product, but just like at the pop-up shop, he seems to have lost the power of speech.
This is where one starts falling down.
Yeah, I'm just...
You've got to keep the communication going.
Yeah.
Keep the customer, because the customer's definitely standing here getting definitely bored to tears.
Yeah, I know. I've noticed that there was an uncomfortable silence, but I've just taken it all in now. So it's really fresh to me. It's really new. So I do apologise about that.
I'll pass you over to one of my other colleagues to deal with you, sir. It may be more appropriate.
Yeah.
Measure across the side, okay? There is a reason for that. Generally, it's dignity.
Okay, yeah.
I think Max has a great deal to learn. He straight seems to struggle and needs to study and look at how he behaves and his selling technique. We're not all natural-born salespeople.
But Max isn't going to change overnight. And from here on in, he's going to have to learn to take a back seat. In 2 weeks' time, Balham is due to get a new boutique, and it's got to offer local shoppers a convenient alternative to the West End. So far, Max and Becky have brought in new dress label Mina, but we still need to secure a major label that has a major pull. I've found one brand that's considering doing business with us. French Connection has been on our high street for 36 years. With its cool, easy-to-wear, fashionable men's and women's collections, it's a big hit with the young professionals, and it's just what Max and Becky need. I've set up a meeting with the label, but they want to be sure that the new Rumplestiltskin is a good match for their brand. Before we go in, I want to give Becky and Max a pep talk.
That you need a high street recognised name in your shop. That will bring in the consumer, you know, because they're going to feel safe. Oh, I recognise that, you know, I know that brand. Now, that will then get people into your shop. It's a safety net with that.
They have to convince the label that their boutique has what it takes to attract the sort of shopper that will wear French Connection.
You've got to really keep this customer in mind, OK? And be confident about who your customer is, because they'll ask you. You know, it is tough because these people don't have to sell to you, you know? They just do not have to. Their brand is bigger than you.
Today, Max and Becky will be going it alone.
And this one's important, guys, because we need this, OK? Good luck, guys.
Hi, Max. I'm Simon.
They have to impress menswear sales manager Simon Belcher and womenswear Sarah Ashley. But before the meeting, they're getting a sneak preview of the latest collection.
So I've put out some looks and some of our bestsellers and from summer 08. Pussy bow shirts, a bit kind of like what I'm wearing now, but this is our new move on for summer.
Okay.
And then floral, there's a lot of floral coming through for summer. This is really pretty, it's got kind of a white lining through it. I mean, I've teamed it up with a waistcoat, but you could wear that with, like, just on its own with a pair of leggings and some little pumps, it'd be really cute. Okay, and then oversized shirting, which again is great and really easy to wear. That you could wear it as, you know, I'd wear it as a little dress, but you could wear it with leggings or over jeans. High waisted trousers, the high waisted baggy trousers, which is really, really on trend. It's very 70s looking.
Yeah. Max and Becky need to soak this up. They're being given the inside track on all the key trends we'll all be following this season.
Another big trend for summer is summer 08 is ruffles. There's lots of ruffles on sleeves, on bottoms of dresses, on dresses all over. And that's a really nice, kind of easier way of doing it on jersey.
Lovely.
So it's not too over the top. Tie-dye is another big kind of on trend thing.
And it's nice to kind of get those bits that you can wear through the day and really just turn them into something really quite elegant in the evening, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, this is the kind of thing, you know, I could wear that during the day to work and then go out in the evening.
Yeah.
And an easy thing to wear, you could take the belt off and, again, they could wear it over
that
something else.
Yeah.
It's just an easy piece.
But Max and Becky can kiss this collection goodbye if they don't present themselves and their new image confidently. They've now got half an hour to make a good impression.
And so tell us a little bit about your shop at the moment. And
we are the first boutique in Benham, and I think that's what's going to make us quite special.
Right.
And how's it been going the last 3 years?
It's been okay, but we haven't had labels that have had good brand identity, and right, that's why we're here today.
You know, one thing I would say is that the brands that you are going to put into your store, that it would be something that needs to complement French Connection sitwear with, you know, not be like a 16, 18-year-old jeans wear brand that would just look really odd.
Having no history with other major labels puts Becky and Max at a disadvantage, so they've got to show they know their business inside out.
Who is your target market?
You know, very affluent. A lot of them are house owners.
Right. What about age group?
Between about 21 to 35 years old.
Right, OK. So quite affluent.
Mm-hmm. So if we can give them the things that you would get in the West End, but on their doorstep, I think we would really kind of clean up.
Textbook answers from the pair of them. But before they're shown the door, Becky's launching a charm offensive.
I think one of the reasons we've looked at French Connection is because French Connection stands really strong on its own already. It's got brand identity, and we need something like that.
Right, OK.
And I think it's something that people recognise and love, and they're confident buying it. And I think we need something strong.
I'll know soon if that was enough to convince French Connection to do business with us.
So are you happy to take the risk with them and sell to them?
The news is in. French Connection have said yes.
We'll make sure the collection looks fantastic. Yeah, brilliant.
Bagging desirable collections has given Rumplestiltskin a lifeline.
That's brilliant news, and they won't let you down, believe you me.
Now we need to get the message out that a piece of the West End is coming to Balham. And I'm going to take our lead from the High Street competition. Hot brands that we know and love work hard creating an image that we all want to buy into. So I'm going to help Max and Becky do the same with their new boutique.
So I want you to do your own ad campaign, OK? I want you to shoot what will be a poster that I want us to put out into the community, OK? Now, I love the idea of shooting real people. Real people who live in Balham and who will shop with you.
I'm loving the idea of that.
Definitely. Mm.
And you actually really start to market to the people who'll be buying it.
Yeah. Mm.
Whilst I've got them excited about the ad campaign, I want to tackle the biggest image problem of all. That name.
And we're going to change the name, right? I love the idea of using Balham in it and it becoming a destination. People thinking, in the future even, we're going to pop to Balham and we're going to go to that boutique. And I think Balham Boo, but B-O-U, which we just think is cute and funky.
Balham Boos. I like it. I like it.
I'm not sure about putting Balham first, but then I see the logic behind it, because it becomes a destination, the whole thing.
It's cute.
Yeah, my boo.
Yeah.
The photo shoot to launch the new Balham Boo is taking place at a studio in North London.
I'm Stefan.
Stefan, Becky.
Nice to meet you.
Stefan Max.
Nice to meet you.
I've enlisted the help of fashion photographer Stefan LeCandler.
I've just had a chat with Stefan on the sort of feel. My gut feel is that we try and keep it as natural as possible. None of the too much of the...
No Zoolander style.
Zoolander.
And we've chosen the faces of Balham Boo. Two of the locals, Becky and Max, styled just a few weeks ago, Catherine and James.
It's quite nerve-wracking.
Oh, no!
And it's going to look good for your shop.
You will look good, you will.
Becky and Max are going to direct the shoot, and they've brought along their new collection.
Yeah, let's try those.
Right, I'll run upstairs.
It's up to Becky to create a look that best represents her boutique.
Just throw this on for me and see what it looks like.
There's another tank. This one might be better.
Oh, God, no. What? That's that. That's cyber crash. Look. No, Max.
Oh, please help me.
If ever I needed confirmation that I'd put the right person in charge of fashion, that was it.
I feel like Woody Allen.
I like it.
Yeah?
I think you work it well. Yeah, I do.
Let's have a shot with that, and then we can look it in the camera and see how it looks.
Ready for your moment of fame.
Are you ready? Just relax. Drop your hands. Drop your hands. You can move around as well. Don't need to stand still.
If this is going to be a success, our first-time models need to feel confident in their outfits.
Swing that skirt a little bit. That's lovely.
You know, keep working it, girlfriend.
That's lovely. Look at me.
You're looking so cute. Yeah, I like it.
No, no, that's cool. That's cool.
Look a little bit more profile for me, but look, don't look at me. Look straight ahead. That's really nice.
It's quite understated.
Yeah.
Try to sort of lean before when you do it, so you get a bit of shape. Yeah, that's nice. I like you when you're smiling. That's lovely. You've never done this before, you say? Look good. Yeah. As in everyone. Yeah, it's a classic.
They've been snapping away, but for this poster campaign, I need one great shot that will stop people in their tracks.
Well done, baby.
That works.
Yeah, that definitely works.
That really works. Fantastic. That's very sort of natural.
Yep.
I feel that I've picked the right outfits, things that really represent what we're all about.
So that one leaning forward?
That
is the one. Yeah.
I mean, you can't get anything better than that, having the people that shop with you actually wearing the clothes in a campaign for your boutique. It's fantastic. Belle & Boo's going to be a real hit.
When I wake up in the morning, there was a time when I wondered if we'd ever get here. But today, we're opening Max and Becky's boutique under a new name.
What do you think? I mean, when you stand out here and see that name and how good it looks, what do you think?
I'm really proud of it. I think we've done really well to get to this point.
We've kept the windows simple. The most powerful thing on show are the clothes. And by using the hottest pieces, we're telling passers-by that Belle & Boo is up to the minute. But I'm not happy yet.
Your windows are filthy. Why haven't we cleaned the windows?
But I'm going to do it in a minute.
Well, we get it cleaned. It's like when you go to a restaurant and someone brings you your dinner and you're spending a premium on your dinner and there's a drip of the gravy all around the edge.
Yeah, it's not nice.
It just doesn't feel good. No. It's not special.
Should we go inside?
5 weeks ago, this boutique looked more like a youth club than a shop that sold fashion. The clothes on the rails were a mixed-up jumble of labels that were only fit for kids. Now, it's been transformed into a grown-up boutique. The decor is classic and contemporary. And now it's the clothes that take centre stage.
And this is the area that I call the decompression zone. OK, so your customer comes in, you walk through the door, and it's their ability then just to stop and think, right, which way shall I go? Instead of being bombarded.
The new collections are in, and I've given Becky and Max a hand in displaying them in a way that catches the eye of the shopper.
And the breaking up of the merchandise with the green and the black just gives this interest all the time that you move from one thing to the next. Doesn't this feel chic and sophisticated? And then I want to move from one part of the shop to the other. That's when you know you've got it right.
Yeah. I want Belle & Boo to specialise in women's wear, so we've brought in a capsule menswear collection from French Connection.
Menswear, 30% of your mix, 70% your women's wear.
The major change to this shop are the new sophisticated clothes. But I don't want anything to fight with that, so we've had to give one old friend the chop.
Hey, do you remember Metal Mickey in a dress? Now, wasn't it? Metal Mickey. You can keep that, Becky. Okay, that could be yes to you. I forget. But you know what? This one, you've got to hang this up. Okay, that is a much, much more sophisticated interpretation.
It's just a shame the same can't be said for all of the boutique.
Where's my mirror, Max? You were meant to hang up my mirror.
It's there.
Hang it up. It's there. I need a mirror hung up. And the hooks.
I will do it.
I want some beautiful hooks. How am I going to hang my frock up if I haven't got a hook on? You know, bang, tonight, got people coming in. Oh, yes, of course you can try on. Oh, chuck your clothes on the floor, madam. What does that say? Look at this disgusting carpet. Get the Hoover out and we need the paint off there.
Yes, definitely.
You know, again, I'm coming into the shop. Might as well put a fag butt on there. Detail. Detail. I am going to pay a premium in your boutique. Look after me.
With just a couple of hours to go till opening time, Max and Becky aren't done yet. Ballon Boo may be opening today, but this isn't a destination for fashion shoppers yet. I'm relying on our poster campaign to put us on the map, and I've bagged us a prime location.
That looks so good!
I've turned the best shots from Max and Becky's photo shoot into a billboard campaign that tells the locals exactly what we're about.
West End is out.
Ballon's in.
West End's out.
Isn't that a good line? Do you like it?
I love it.
West End out, Ballon in.
Definitely.
Look at it.
That looks great.
Don't they look so good, though?
They really do. And these are our customers.
These are your customers. That's what customers. I just love about this. I really do think that's strong. And I think you've styled it. It's all your own work. You've bought that collection.
Yep.
That's your business.
Yep. Sophisticated.
Being at the tube station means the poster is guaranteed to be seen by those young professionals on their way to and from the office.
The amount of people crossing that crossing, that's what you call opportunity to see, OTS. And that is a very, very powerful place to be. You couldn't get better.
Now we have to hope that those Ballamites buy into the idea of shopping local. It's time to throw open the doors of Ballon Boo.
Hello. Hello, have you a glass of champagne?
Hi. Have a shop and we'll get you a glass of champers.
There you go.
Ladies is now on the right and Mindy is on the left.
So are all you guys local?
Yeah.
What, an estate agent?
Yeah.
Well, how's it like it? There you go, Kate. Thanks, baby. What do you think to it?
It looks a little bit more plush. It looks good. I like it.
We're opening tonight for just a few hours, and this is a big test for Becky. She needs to create a real buzz. These customers need to hit that shopping high they get when they go to the West End.
There's some great new labels. We've got Aloha, which is pure silk.
These glasses are absolutely gorgeous.
They are really gorgeous. So is this a label you've used before?
No, this is brand new.
I really like this.
This is brand new and this is gorgeous, isn't it?
People around here do wear this kind of stuff.
Exactly.
They really do.
I like this dress.
That's fantastic, that piece.
It's beautiful, isn't it?
Yes, it's very
and
nice.
And I like black at the moment, but I want something more cheerful as well. So I'm always wearing black. I think my husband's getting thinner.
Let's go for this one as well.
That's nice.
That's fantastic, and it's loose and easy to wear.
The new collections are going down well, but it's Becky's understanding of how to dress well that's really getting these shoppers excited.
I love this because this is kind of almost oriental sort of look.
Yeah, and it's really sheer but still gives you that jacket feel.
So it's a nice piece, you can wear it out in the evening maybe.
Absolutely.
Just on its own, or you could put it team it with a polo neck or a jumper underneath.
It's gorgeous, and even if you don't like it with that, you could wear it with a black skinny fit jean.
How cute you look. Your boobies look great.
Oh, I love this. Thank you. Thanks for your help.
Thank you.
All the attention.
Max, for once, is the quietest person in the room. He's supporting Becky, but letting her take centre stage.
No, this one's £95.
Thank you very much.
And that makes you feel better.
At the moment, I'm playing more of a low-key role, so I'm just stepping back, letting the customer enjoy the product, and then if they need me, then I can come in and help. These ones are £85 now. You have two colour options, so it comes in a black as well.
No, he's just a different Max. He's not full-on Max. Do you want to buy it? Do you want to buy it? No, he's letting people look. He's letting them take their time and enjoy their surroundings. Before, I used to feel like he was chasing them out of the store, but he's learnt very well.
I might have put Max in the back seat, but his mentor, Rowley, has left swanky German Street to show his support.
Nice to see you again. My mentor.
No, hang on. How do you greet him? Hans
Brother! Hello, sir.
Good afternoon.
Lovely to see you.
Lovely to see
you. Like a glass of champagne?
He's kind. The service is impeccable.
See, that's what. I don't know who trained him, but he must have had a bit of a few tips that he handed on. What do you think?
This is wonderful.
That and that together.
Nice little.
Yeah, that'd be
We've had more new customers in the shop than Max and Becky would usually have had in an entire month. But have we done enough to convince them to shop local?
It's excellent. I think it's just what Balham needs.
It's definitely Oxford Street, isn't it? And, you know,
In Balham,
we've got Oxford Street in Balham. Oh, I think that's marvellous.
Yeah, it's nice to get a bit of the high street here too.
Do you know, that is so handy, because really you don't have lovely. To... Like, as the whole thing is going up to town, which is a nightmare.
No more going up to town.
No more.
And the clearest sign that Balham Boo works is at the cash desk.
That's £2.25, please.
In just an afternoon, they've taken £3,600, more than Becky and Max would usually take in an entire week.
And your receipts are in the bank.
Thank you very much, and thanks for all your help.
Thank
I appreciate
you very
that
much.
A lot.
Have a lovely evening. Bye-bye. Good sign, eh? Good sign.
Brilliant sign. Do you feel confident?
I do, Mary. Thank you very much.
You just get that confidence back, my darling, in your buy, in everything you do.
I really appreciate it.
Right, from there, OK? Right. Well, see you guys.
Your see pen. You later. Thank you, Mary.
I do think I know everything already, and I evidently don't.
Well, I can keep these changes strong in this business and not slide back to where we were before. No way. I'm going to enjoy coming to work from now on.
I believe there is a business that will work in Balham. We've got the collections right, we know that. We've seen the right customer in there tonight. The shop looks fantastic. It's all done. It's up to them now.
2 months since we launched Balham Boo, and it's still looking like a professional boutique on the outside. And inside, the locals have been shopping up a storm.
We are
people
new.
Come
yeah,
now
yeah,
and
yeah.
say, oh, are you new? Are you new? How long have you been here? Yeah. So they really couldn't see us. It was almost like there was a black sheet over
that's
this
right.
shop.
That's right.
And somebody's lifted that sheet off that's and everyone can see us now. Right. And, you know, it's amazing. Yeah. They're actually purchasing it. It's not a load of lip service.
Just as I hoped, the new collections have tempted the locals from shopping elsewhere. And Becky's already been buying in some new pieces.
This is another label that I bought in called Vera Moda. And every lady that tries this dress on has bought it. Everything in here is cherry-picked. I take time to think about what I pick before I put it on the shop because I want my customer to be happy.
Although Becky's taking the lead on what gets stocked at Balham Boo, Max is still keeping his hand in. In fact, he's now the store's self-appointed visual merchandiser.
Bet, do you want to put the jacket on the other mannequin, yeah?
No problem.
I'll just check this outside. I'm into the whole merchandising thing and I really, really, really enjoy it.
Max and Becky's newfound passion is paying off. Their takings have doubled. And already, the Balham Boo effect is working. A new boutique has opened just round the corner.
I'm actually really happy that they're there.
That's right, yeah.
It doesn't faze me that they're there. You know, I'm glad because it brings the whole area up. Balham is now a destination to come to shop that's for fashion.
That's right. It's exactly what, you know, people want in this area.